And we begin with this new tonight. KCRA 3 has obtained video of parole agents searching inside the Antioch home of convicted kidnappers Philip and Nancy Garrido.
We're also learning how the couple kept agents from discovering J.C. Dugard and her daughters for years.
KCRA's Damani Lewis explains what prosecutors could have used if Philip and Nancy Garrido went to trial.
We've been sleeping in there.
For 18 years, Philip and Nancy Garrido were able to dupe parole agents and hide J.C. Dugard and her two children in their backyard in Antioch.
If you stay in this front room, and I don't have to place you in restraint.
And this video recorded by Nancy Garrido may give the blueprint on how the couple did it.
I don't believe it either.
I think he got worked.
Cecil Canton, former 14-year New York State Correctional Service Assistant Commissioner and now Sacramento State Professor, carefully examined this one parole agent's visit at the Garridos and noticed several mistakes.
I wonder how many times that parole agent had been to that home. And if that was his first time, then he didn't exhibit much curiosity about what was there.
Another red flag, he says the Garridos perfectly distracted the agent whenever they could. A prime example is when Nancy Garrido started throwing out questions at the officer.
What does a parole agent do for his parolee?
Now he's annoyed because he realizes that they're just on him, and I know what he wants to do right now is just get out of there.
Kenton says he's surprised the agent allowed Garrido to give the tour of the house instead of taking control and performing his own search anywhere in the house or on the property.
There is no place on that property that's off limits to that parole agent.
Why not?
Because that parolee has no particular rights.
In Sacramento, Damani Lewis, KCRA 3 Night Team.
J.C. Dugard's memoir was released just a couple of hours ago. We downloaded it on an e-reader, and coming up in about 10 minutes, we'll take a look at some of the topics she details in that book.